the most important thing, like the subjective question, because it covers like 50 marks from a subjective question, and there will be two questions. So if you will follow the paper pattern of 2004 and before, you will find that questions basically come from constitutional law, jurisprudence, contract, or tort, or other contemporary issues. And so you like those who are preparing for last 20 days, or anybody who is preparing, so last 20 days focus should be only on these subjects. In constitutional law, you will be thinking like what can come in the constitution. So the question will be very like analytical question. They are not going to ask direct question to you. There will be some passage or there will be some case study type of thing. So you have to analyze it. And if you will, you and when you get any question of this type, you read that passage at least two or three times. Every time you will read, you will find it very different. You will have a different way for writing the answer. Like what, when we were in college, when we were preparing, like we used to prepare for moot court. So every time we read the moot problem, we find a different angle in the problem. So likewise, if any question of case study type come, you should read that question at least two or three times so that before writing your answer. Right. So in constitutional law, questions can come from like recent constitutional development which has taken place. Questions can come from that, like a question from privacy, right to privacy can come. And if any question like of privacy come, you have to relate it with Aadhaar. All right. Then question of triple talaq and women rights can come. Also freedom of speech and expression questions, like from questions from these areas can come. And in constitutional law, if we talk about the provision, you for subjective questions, you must know part three very carefully, that question, because most of the development in constitution has taken in part three. So you must know very carefully that thing, and emergency provisions also. You must be very careful, and you must know all the important landmark judgments of the Supreme Court with respect to these provisions, right? Like if question come from amendment, so you must know all the sequence of cases and sequence of development which has taken place with respect to amendment. Then jurisprudence. So in this also they are going to ask questions like what was the controversy in Hart-Fuller debate. So questions will be like this only. They are not going to say like what is analytical rule. They will say that Austin believes that jurisprudence is a science of positive law, like that. So you have to comment on that. You will have to, your question has to be, your answer has to be critically analyzed. So when you are reading the theory part from the book, you also think like why this. You always try to answer why question in every. So it will help you to know the topic in a very broader way. If you stick to all the contents given in the book, then you will not be able to write proper answer. So every time you ask why question from yourself, that why Austin said like this? What was the background of the Austin? If you know the background of the Austin, you will find that he was an army man. And army people are always like, they follow the order of the higher authority. So he says that law is a command of sovereign. So you must know the background of picture also. So these are the few of the techniques while writing the answers. Then question from contract, it can be like question from frustration of contract can come, question of contingent contract, and any of the case laws which are like from section 15 to section 19, case laws which, because there are many cases with respect to coercion, undue influence, fraud, misrepresentation. So they will tell one of the operating part of the judgment, and you will have to answer. So whenever any question of this type come, you first write the basic thing like introduction, and then statutory provision, then case clause, and then conclusion. So you have to structure your answer very properly. Then comes tort. So in tort also, there will be questions will be from like what are the general defenses in tort. Whenever any authority makes the question, they don't make every question very tough. So it is very like there will be question of easy level, then medium, and then tough. So in subjective part also, what I believe, question of three categories will be surely there, and you will also have an option. So at least 5 minutes you read the questions very carefully, and then think which part you can answer properly, right? So in tort you need to focus about like if you will see the Damanam sign injuria, the Bhim Singh case, and then there's one Ashby case. So they will narrate the operating part of the judgment, and you will have to think, like, then you will have to involve the constitutional provision, then you, what, like, whatever knowledge you have, you put in there. And that has to be, like, very, you don't have to write in a broader way. You have to write the depth of answer, right? You should, it should not be like you write everything you know. You have to write the selective thing only, and proper underlining of the important article in case laws. Use black and blue pen proper to underline all those things. So take proper time. You should not be in a hurry. Like, be relaxed, because many times what the people do, they are in hurry and they start committing mistakes on life. Then one of the other area of subjective questions will be contemporary issues, because CLAT authorities have specifically mentioned this thing. So there will be surely one or two questions from contemporary issues. And contemporary issues can be like Aadhaar verdict, you can see, then verdict of like with respect to triple talaq also. And you list out all the recent developments which has taken. I will circulate a list for contemporary issues to Sudipta, and he will circulate with you all. So it will be very easy for all of you. Then comes the writing skills part, like how you have to frame your answer. See, when I was in college, in my graduation, post-graduation, my answer sheet used to be a model answer. Because I used to write in such a way, like if any topic comes, like let's say the topic of right to privacy comes. Okay. So first thing what you have to do, you have to write introduction. You, like, basic things, like you have to use proper quotes. And if you remember the author of somebody, or you remember the line of some jurist, you start with that, like in the words of Abraham Lincoln, or in the words of Justice Bhagwati. Okay. In this way, you have to start your answer, because it will then, the first line when the examiner will see, he will be impressed. All right. And then whatever you have written down, it can be ignored. All right. So starting has to be very beautiful, and ending has to be very beautiful. So start with the introduction, right? Then concept. Then what are the case laws and statutory provision related to that thing? And then you have to write your conclusion also, conclusion and suggestion. Conclusion if the question is direct, and suggestion if the question is where you, if the answer is seeking your views. So you have to give suggestion also. And stick to the word limit very carefully. Do not exceed the word limit. And I think there won't be extra sheet also. Extra sheet won't be provided. So you have to write your answer within that limit only. So write the quality answer. Don't use quantity. I'll strictly say. When I gave NLU Delhi paper, so that time question, there were like two options. Three questions were, four, I think four questions were there. So I wrote question for right to privacy. And I was also in very hurry. Like I just had 20 minutes time to write the answer. I was not knowing like what to write. I was confused. So you should not commit that thing. And when I started writing, I was not knowing anything. I like put all the quantity material. You know. There was no quality, but I don't know how I secured the 33 rank, because it may be because I scored very good in objective part. So writing skills is a very important thing, and it plays a very crucial role in securing good marks. So be very careful and be optimistic. Be relaxed while writing subjective question. And don't jump, like you start writing subjective question and then you again move to objective, then subjective, then objective. First complete either subjective and then go to the objective. You have to, it's up to you only. You have to choose that. Alright. And there may be a chance that you start reading the first question and you are not able, you don't know anything about that question. Then you don't lose your temperament. You read another question. You think, you like, what you have to do is that you read that question multiple times until you get to something clicks in your mind. Alright. If in case, out of like, if there are four questions and you have to write two, all the four questions you don't know anything. In that case, again, you make proper heading. I'm sure that being a law student, being like after completing 5-year law, you must be able to relate anything to that topic, anything which comes. So relate it with the constitution. Every answer you have to relate it to the constitution. Then it will help you to score good marks. All right. So in that case also, proper headings and proper underlining should be done. All the case.